Hi, I'm Susan Arndt, and this is the video supplement for our review of LEGO Harry Potter. If you enjoy the LEGO series of games and are a Harry Potter fan, then honestly, just don't even bother with the rest of this video. Seriously, you're gonna love the game, trust me, so just go on, because you don't need to hear any of this. Now, in case you're not familiar with how LEGO games work, however, they follow the plot lines of films, in this case the first four Harry Potter movies, and present you with a series of obstacles that you have to overcome by manipulating your LEGO environment, usually by breaking it apart or putting it back together. As you might expect from a game centered on students at a school for wizards, moving forward usually involves crafting a potion or casting a spell, but you'll have to hop on a broom sometimes too. The challenge of the game comes from figuring out what you need to do in order to open the door or find the last potion ingredient. When in doubt, just shoot everything. You don't have to be a fan of Harry Potter to have fun with LEGO Harry Potter, but it certainly helps, because the game does such a fantastic job of recreating the world represented in the movies. Recognizing details and locations like potions class, or the portrait of the fat lady that leads to Gryffindor's dorm, or the Quidditch pitch, or the shops in Diagon Alley, really adds immensely to your enjoyment of the game. All your favorite characters are there, of course. Harry, Ron, Hermione, Hagrid, Dumbledore, Snape, Malfoy. But you've also got smaller characters like Colin Creevy, Madame Pomfrey, and even Moaning Myrtle. Knowledge of the source material can also be helpful when it comes to actual gameplay. Like knowing that a surefire way to get Filch to leave you alone is to mess with his cat, Mrs. Norris. If you're still stuck, just shoot everything. Almost all the action in the Harry Potter movies takes place during the school year, so naturally you'll attend some classes and learn new spells and abilities as you progress through the game. You'll eventually end up with a nice assortment, including Harry's invisibility cloak, a spell to immobilize pixies, and the ability to safely deal with mandrakes, but you really end up using the same two spells over and over again. You'll levitate things to put them together and zap them to blow them apart. Blowing things apart is important because that nets you studs, which you can use to buy unlockables like extra costumes and silly bonus modes that do things like turn your wand into a carrot. Studs are just one thing to collect, though. You'll also be hunting for extra characters, boxes for Hedwig, and bits of the Hogwarts crest. To find absolutely everything, you'll have to replay levels and take advantage of characters' individual abilities. Harry's really good on a broom, Hermione can open book cupboards, Ron can send scabbards into pipes, Hagrid's really strong, and so on. Just remember, no matter what character you're using, oh, you know.